Von. This is Igor Vasily. He works with me at the Bureau.
Charmed, I'm sure. Niels has told me so much about you.
I'm sorry, but I'll be late for the ferry. Niels, I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. Goodbye.
Thanks.
She's quite attractive.
What's happening at the office?
Everything is dead quiet. It seems almost eerie. Do you still have the red document?
Why?
Headquarters wants to know. Is it here? Is it safe?
It's not here, but it's safe.
You're going to need help in this, Henry. You can trust me.
I'll manage. I didn't know that I was going to marry such a good cook.
I shall have to learn Swedish cooking.
American's fine.
I wrote to my parents yesterday and told them to get ready for a wedding as soon as the war is over. Your family will come, won't they?
There's really only my father.
I must go.
I wish you didn't have to.
So do I. But they lock the orphanage gates at 9 o'clock. At least you don't have a fever now.
That's what you think. I love you, Molly.
I love you too. Nils, I'm not going.
Molly, are you sure?
I'm sure. I must get back before they miss me.
I'll go with you.
Isn't it strange that we've only known each other in wartime? I mean, what if when the war is over, we're two different people?
Someone said that to me once before.
Was it a girl?
Her name was Vicky. It was in London, and we were in love with each other, but we didn't get married. And she said that we could be two different people after the war. I shouldn't have told you.
No, no. I'm glad that you did. Let's always be honest with each other.
We will.
You know, I feel selfish thinking about the wedding with the war still going on. But I can't wait to start planning it. I wish I was your wife now. My parents would say that what we did last night was a sin.
Do you think that it was?
I don't know. I just know I love you. And I trust you.
And I love you.
She wants to tell your fortune.
Oh, no, Nils.
Come on, I love these fortune tellers. They always tell you what you want to hear.
Eh?
Come on, Mom.
All right.
You have to ask her a question.
Will our love last forever?
Ir permitsi servelemi.
Seven.
Here, put my coat on.
Oh! Come on, Nils. I've got to hurry.
What do you want?
Mr. Anderson?
Who gave this to you? Hey!
What happens if our double agent has informed the war minister? You need help.
I have to do this alone.
And if you don't return, who takes over here?
You will. You're the only one I trust.
So you are taking Red Document with you?
Yeah.
You have it on you now?
No, I'll pick it up on the way.
You take care. You are a target, you know, with that document.
Come with me.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes.
This way.
Come in, Mr. Anderson. Have you heard of the Mevlevihane?
Yes, sir. It's a sort of spiritual brotherhood celebrating the belief of a 13th century mystic, known as Mevlana.
Vulgarly known in the West as the Whirling Dervishes, Mevlana believed that human beings were composed of spirit, reason, and love, which they could combine to make a representation of heaven on earth. Their dancing represents the ecstasy of achieving this unity. Absurd superstition, no? Such a beautiful ambition. Of course, I don't believe it.
Hey, man, you gotta listen. I think you have something for me.
Yes, sir.
What is this? This is not from the French government. It is signed by an officer in French intelligence.
What is your position in all this?
These are not the terms which I was given to believe.
Terms? This document doesn't offer terms. It's a barefaced bribe. If I will agree to give Syria to France and hand over our border states to the Allies, then the French will help me to overthrow the Sultan and Enver Pasha and put me in charge of a puppet republic. Mr. Anderson, if that is your name, which I doubt, you may have been led to believe that all Turks can be bribed. But I can assure you, that is not true.
Sir, I'm sure that there's room for negotiation. If you were to make a separate peace, it would at least save lives.
These people are not interested in that. Like vultures feeding on the dying carcass of the Ottoman Empire. The Empire is dying, but this nation is not. And it will not die as long as I live.
700 years of Anatolian tradition. But we must move on. I dream of an independent new Turkey. When that's a reality, your spy masters will not dare to treat me like a Mongolian warlord.
I'm sorry, sir.
Believe me, I shall achieve my dream, but not through that. There, man. Onu dışarı çıkarın. Mr. Anderson, get that out of my sight.
Do you have the document? Come quickly.
Where?
Come.
Get your hands off of me.
I think I know who the wolf is. And he may suspect I know. You must get rid of that paper. It'd kill for me.
Yeah, I'm sure he would.
You think it's me?
I don't know who it is. You haven't told me yet.
You think it's me?
Sadama?
Çay.
Did you see Kim Mao before he left?
Not interested. He threw this back in my face.
Sadala is not here yet.
Sadala's dead. He was shot in the back. Before he died, he gave me a clue as to who the wolf is. I know it's one of you. I've closed down the agency. I want everybody to lie low until I contact them.
Are you sure Sadala isn't the wolf?
I'm not sure of anything anymore. Check around and everybody will come back from headquarters tomorrow. Then I'll know. What's wrong?
How could you? Mustafa Kemal sent a letter around to Halide and she came to tell me. It said, did you know that your Swedish journalist was a French spy? You are a spy. You used my friendship with Halide to get to Mustafa Kemal, didn't you?
No, Molly.
So Mustafa Kemal was lying?
No, Molly, but it's not like that.
Well, what is it like?
Molly, it's true that I work for French intelligence.
But you didn't trust me enough to tell me.
No, Molly, I just didn't want to involve you.
Involve me? Did you know that Halide said that to the Turks, I am an enemy alien? And if I put one foot wrong, I could be deported. You know how much my work at the orphanage means to me, and you involve